This is five reasons why the Miami Heat have a potential chance to win the NBA Finals of 2020. This is the case for the Miami Heat to win the NBA championship. Could it happen? Could it actually happen? We'll have to wait and find out. But these are five things that I believe give Miami a case for the NBA championship this season. This video is a two-part episode series where obviously right now we're looking at the Miami Heat. And in the next episode, which should be out tomorrow or the day after, I'll edit that video after I edit this video. We're going to look at the Los Angeles Lakers, who obviously they're the favorites to win the NBA championship. So I think this video should be a lot more interesting. But without further ado, let's get into it. I'd love if you guys could help me out though by hitting that like button. It really does help the channel and it helps me out a ton. If you're new and you enjoy NBA content, hit that subscribe button for NBA content every single week. That notification bell is always available if you want to be notified every time I upload a new video. And comment down below, do you give the Miami Heat a chance to win the NBA championship? And without further ado, let's get on to the video. At number five, the Miami Heat can defend LeBron James and actually limit his impact that many teams are not able to do. Obviously, Jimmy Butler is one of the greatest defenders the league has seen this past decade and this year alone. We know that wherever he's always been a talented defender. From the Chicago Bulls days, to Minnesota, to Philadelphia, no matter where he went, he was always an elite defender. And we've seen him give LeBron James some problems in the NBA playoffs and just during his time with the Chicago Bulls, where they needed Jimmy to step up on the defensive end, because he's one of those players that is big enough and strong enough to actually match up against a player like LeBron James, who's just dominated the league since he entered in 2003. But the one thing about the Miami Heat is that they don't just have Jimmy Butler. They've got Andre Iguodala, a veteran player now, but he's always been somebody who's been able to defend LeBron James, not necessarily to stop him from going off for 30, 25 points, but just limit his impact where other players cannot. LeBron is a player that you can really only limit to a certain extent. He's one of the greatest players of all time, but if you have Jimmy Butler, Andre Iguodala, and now also Jay Crowder, it does give LeBron James some problems when he's matched up one-on-one against one of those three defenders. They're all big enough to face off against LeBron, and they're also very smart players that have played LeBron previously and know his tendencies. But the formula on the defensive end to stop LeBron doesn't just end there. They've also got Eric Spoelstra, one of the greatest head coaches in the NBA, but he also knows how to defend LeBron. We've seen this in past NBA games where when LeBron James returned to Cleveland after his time in Miami and when he's played for the Los Angeles Lakers, Eric Spoelstra has always done a decent job on LeBron. They've been able to switch players onto LeBron. If there's a pick and roll, they always bring an extra player to match up on LeBron and double team him when he drives the hoop. I think that's something that will be very valuable in this NBA Finals series. And not to mention, LeBron James has also been a player under Eric Spoelstra for 4 years. Spo was able to coach LeBron for 4 straight years, knowing his tendencies, what he likes, what he doesn't like. So limiting LeBron James is a major factor for the Miami Heat. Will it be easy? Definitely not. But they have the opportunities with 3 great defenders and a head coach who's coached LeBron and knows what he likes and what he doesn't like. In addition, because of the zone that the Miami Heat will probably play just to stop LeBron, LeBron will need to rely on his open shooters, but his shooters haven't really been hitting shots. Danny Green's averaging less than 1.9 threes during the NBA playoffs, Caldwell Pope is averaging just over 2, and Kyle Kuzma's only averaging about 1 3. Which means that if the Miami Heat have a plan to stop LeBron, those players will have to step up and hit open shots, which they haven't been doing during the NBA playoffs. At number 4, they match up overall very well against the Los Angeles Lakers. Anthony Davis hasn't really had to match up on someone like Bam Adebayo yet in these playoffs. He's matched up against tall players like Nurkic and Whiteside in the first round, but neither of those players are great defenders. Sure, Whiteside is a valuable shot blocker, but he's not a great one-on-one defender, and neither is Nurkic. Then in the second round, they matched up against the Houston Rockets, and as we know, they run the small ball lineup, which means that Anthony Davis didn't really play on anybody his size and was able to utilize that to his advantage. Then they matched up against the Denver Nuggets, and Jokic isn't a great defender, but he was primarily on Dwight Howard, so that left Millsap and Mason Plumlee, who didn't really bring much defensively on Anthony Davis and allowed him to play very well during the series. None of those players mentioned, though, bring what Bam Adebayo brings. He has the height, he has the speed, he has the quickness, and he has the versatility. Sure, Anthony Davis is one of the greatest power forward, if not the greatest power forward in the game, but Bam Adebayo is quickly becoming one of the better defensive players the league has, and he will be a tough matchup for Anthony Davis. At number 3, the only two matchups of the 2019 season were in the first quarter of the NBA season. Sure, Miami did lose in both games, but you have to look at the games to actually understand the context. Firstly, Miami has improved a lot as a team just throughout the regular season, but obviously throughout these NBA playoffs where they've really become one of the best and most tight-knit groups the NBA has. So we have to rewind back to the first meeting that came all the way back in November 6th of 2019, almost a year ago. It was just the 6th game of Miami's season and the 8th game of the Lakers' season. That means Tyler Hero and Kendrick Nunn had played a total of 6 NBA games. 6 NBA games. Let me repeat that. 6 league games. Duncan Robinson didn't have the confidence that he has now as one of the best 3-point shooters the league has. Jimmy Butler had played a total of 6 games as well in a Miami Heat uniform, and he was still getting comfortable with his new teammates. Bam Adebayo was starting to find his groove as a new starting center for a team that didn't have Hassan Whiteside anymore, and they hadn't yet traded for Jay Crowder, who's now a starter for this Miami Heat team, Andre Iguodala, who's one of the better defensive players and a great veteran for this team, and Goran Dragic was coming off the bench. Then you fast forward to the second matchup of the season, which was only a month later, in December of last year. It was a much closer contest than the first game of the season, where Miami actually had a chance to tie the game with the Butler 3-point shot at the buzzer. Yet, they were only getting the team together at that point, and the team looks a lot better now than it did then. Whereas LeBron James and Anthony Davis were always the main focal point of the Lakers offense, both then and now. Which means it's a very exciting time for the Miami Heat, who, even though they're 0-2 against the Lakers throughout the regular season, it was only in the first part of the NBA season, and they look a totally different side now in the NBA playoffs and now in the NBA finals. At number 2, the Miami Heat just have so many options better than the Los Angeles Lakers. The Lakers do have the two best players in the series in LeBron James and Anthony Davis, and that isn't a question. But Miami probably has the next 6 to 7 best players in the series. They've got Jimmy Butler, who's better than any third option for the Lakers, Bam Adebayo, Goran Dragic, Tyler Hero, Duncan Robinson, who both play a major role for this Miami Heat team, and then they've got players like Jay Crowder, Andre Iguodala, and the truth about the Miami Heat is that you never know which player will step up and who it will be. Any player can step up for this Miami Heat team and can emerge as a match winner for this team. Whereas the Lakers, they really only have 2 great players, and then they're really just based on a defensive side. Obviously, Rondo and Dwight Howard have both stepped up for the Lakers during this NBA postseason, but neither of them are great offensive players. They're both just very valuable on the defensive end. Whereas for Miami, they have the defense in Jay Crowder, Jimmy Butler, Andre Iguodala, Bam Adebayo, but they also have the offensive firepower in Jimmy Butler, Bam Adebayo, Tyler Hero, Duncan Robinson, Goran Dragic, and overall, if the teams match up, it's a matter of who is a better overall team, and in my opinion, I think that's the Miami Heat. And at number 1, they've simply made it this far. With so many doubters and naysayers already, it's shaping up to be one of those years where an underdog team wins. I mean, you just look at the whole 2020 NBA season, it's a weird season in itself. I gave an analogy in my last video to the 2004 Pistons team, comparing them to this year's Miami Heat team. Only a few hours later, JJ Redick came out and said the exact same things, which gave me a lot of confidence in myself as an NBA YouTuber and a basketball analyst on the platform that a player in the NBA and a good player in the league was saying the same things that I had said a day earlier. He talked about the Miami Heat being compared to the 04 Pistons, which I said. They do give me glimpses of the 2004 Detroit Pistons when they won their NBA championship.
You know, the 04, let's say the 04 Pistons beating the Lakers. Like this is what this team reminds me of, the 04 Pistons.
He talked about the Miami Heat having the better overall team instead of the two best players, which I said. That is why the Miami Heat actually faced off well against the Lakers, because the Lakers realistically only have their 2 main stars in LeBron James and Anthony Davis. And if you are able to match up against them well, you can beat this team.
Well, the Lakers had the 2 best, but after that, the rest of the best players in that series all play for the Heat.
So there were a lot of things that I took away from what he said that made me realize that we're seeing things on the exact same page. And his philosophy is that if you have a better overall team, you will always be the better team. And we're going to see if that's right.
If the Miami Heat win the NBA Finals, it affirms everything that I believe about basketball.
So with that being said, these are the reasons I believe the Miami Heat have a chance to win the NBA championship. Tomorrow, I'll be looking at the Los Angeles Lakers and giving my reasons why they will have a chance to win the NBA championship. With that said, let me know what you thought about this. Let me know down below in the comment section if you believe the Miami Heat have a chance to win the NBA championship. Please help me out by hitting that like button if you enjoyed the video and found it useful. Subscribe if you're new, hit that notification button to stay updated, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. I'm out. Peace.